Hey everybody, my name is Tom, and welcome to Kingdom Kids. Now, in Kingdom Kids, we have three rules. Are you ready? Okay, slap your legs for rule number one. Rule number one is to listen to your teachers. So reach up in the sky, grab your listening ears, and put them on. Good. All right. Here we go for rule number two. Rule number two is to believe that God loves you this much. Yeah. All right. Here we go for rule number three. Rule number three is to do your homework. Wait. That's not rule number three. Do your dirty dishes. Hmm? No, that's not it either. Oh yeah. Do your best. Yeah, whatever we do, we have to do our best. Now, are you ready to play a fun game? Yeah, me too. Okay, clap with me to get to the fun game. One, two, three. Oh, cool. I'm in Kingdom Kids, the video game. And this is how you play. We have three moves we can do. The first one is to run. And then sometimes we might have to jump. And then sometimes we might have to duck. Okay? So run. Jump or duck. Got it? Okay. And in this game, we are trying to get the treasure. Now, to open the treasure chest, we're going to need to get three gold keys. Okay? Are you guys ready? Set. Go. Start running. Oh no, it's a fireball. Jump. Whoa. Okay. Another fireball! Jump again! Oh, I wonder where all those fireballs are coming from. Hopefully it's not from a dragon! Duck! Whew! That was a close one. Alright. Look! Our first gold key! Jump and grab it! Oh! Good job! It's feeling a little windy. Hey! Is that a tornado? Oh, run fast! Yikes! We barely made it! Look! A lightning bolt! Let's grab it! Ooh! Maybe next time we should jump over those. Okay, let's keep running! Look! Our second key! Jump and grab it! Good job! Tornado! Run! Fireball! Jump! Dragon! Duck! There it is! Our last key! Jump really high! Whoa! Got it! I think we're gonna make it! Look! There's the treasure! We did it! We got the treasure! We won the game! Great job. Well, today we're going to learn about the greatest treasure that God could ever give us. But before we do, stay standing and we're going to sing a song of worship together. And remember, I want to see who can sing the loudest, the boys or the girls. I'll see you back in just a minute.
Just one word. You calm the storm that surrounds me. Just one word, the darkness has to retreat. Just one touch, I feel the presence of heaven. Just one touch, my eyes were open to see. My heart can't help but believe. There's no nothing that our God can't do. There's not a mountain that he can't move. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that our God can't do. Just one word, you heal what's broken inside.
I don't know, boys. The girls were singing awful loud. All right. So, like I said, we are going to be talking about the greatest treasure that God could ever give us. But before we start, I'm going to need my Bible. There we go. Why did the turtle cross the road to get to the Shell station? My dad jokes book. Ugh, I've got to get better. What I need is my Bible. Much better. So you guys can go ahead and sit down and turn up your listening ears because we're going to learn from God's word today. And I'm so excited because today we're going to learn about the best treasure in the world. We're going to be in the New Testament in the book of Matthew, chapter 1, Luke, chapter 2, and the book of John, chapter 1. One day, an angel told a girl named Mary that she was going to have a very special baby. The angel explained, "This baby will be God's son." Then an angel appeared to Joseph in a dream. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. Mary's baby was put there by the Holy Spirit. Name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. Jesus, God in the flesh, would come as a light into the dark world." Mary and Joseph lived in a town called Nazareth. The Roman Emperor Caesar Augustus announced that everyone needed to return to their own towns to be registered for a census.
Since Joseph was the descendant of King David, he and Mary traveled to Bethlehem, the city of David. The time came for Mary to have her baby. He and Mary looked all around for a safe place to stay, but every place was full. So Mary and Joseph found a place where animals were kept, and that is where Mary had her baby. Joseph named him Jesus. That night, some shepherds were watching over their sheep in the fields near Bethlehem. Suddenly, an angel stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. The angel said, "I have very good news for you and all the people. Today, a Savior who is the Messiah and the Lord was born for you in the city of David." Suddenly, a whole army of angels appeared, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven and peace on earth to people he favors." The shepherds decided to go straight to Bethlehem to see what had happened. They hurried to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the baby. Then the shepherds went and told others about baby Jesus. The shepherds returned to their fields, praising God because everything had happened just as the angel had said. You see, the biggest treasure God could ever give us is himself. And Jesus, who is God, gave us himself by coming into the world. Now, let's watch this Kingdom Kids recap video.
Mary was engaged to be married to Joseph. One day, an angel told Mary she was going to have a very special baby. The angel explained, "This baby will be God's son." Then an angel appeared to Joseph in a dream. The angel said, "Don't be afraid to take Mary as your wife. Her baby was put there by the Holy Spirit. Name him Jesus because he will save his people from their sins." This was amazing news. Jesus, God in the flesh, would come as a light into the dark world. Mary and Joseph lived in the town of Nazareth. During the time Mary was pregnant, the Roman Emperor, Caesar Augustus, announced that everyone needed to return to their own towns and be registered for a census. Since Joseph was a descendant of King David, he and Mary traveled to Bethlehem, the city of David. While they were there, the time came for Mary to have her baby. Mary and Joseph looked for a safe place to stay, but every place was full. So Mary and Joseph found a place where animals were kept, and that is where Mary had her baby. Joseph named him Jesus. Mary wrapped the baby tightly in cloth and laid him in a feeding trough. That night, some shepherds were watching over their sheep in the fields near Bethlehem. Suddenly, an angel stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them. They were terrified. The angel said, "Don't be afraid. I have very good news for you and for all the people. Today, a Savior who is the Messiah and the Lord was born for you in the city of David." Then the angel said, "You will find a baby wrapped tightly in cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a whole army of angels appeared, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven and peace on earth to people he favors." When the angels left and returned to heaven, the shepherds decided to go straight to Bethlehem and see what had happened. They hurried to Bethlehem and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the feeding trough. Then the shepherds went and told others about the baby Jesus. Everyone who heard about Jesus was amazed. Mary thought about everything that was happening and tried to understand it. The shepherds returned to their fields, praising God, because everything had happened just as the angels said.
And here's today's Christ Connection. The birth of Jesus was good news. Jesus was not an ordinary baby. He is God's Son, sent to earth from heaven. Jesus, the promised Savior, came into the world to show us what God is like and to rescue us from sin and death. In the book of John, chapter 1, verse 14, it says, "And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, and we have seen his glory, glory as of the only Son from the Father, full of grace and truth." And I have three questions for you to talk about with your teacher and your class. Question number one, why is Jesus' birth good news for us? Question number two, what did Jesus do to save us? And question number three, what is the greatest treasure God can give us? Those were good answers. Now, let's pray together. Jesus, thank you so much for being born into the world to save us and to give us yourself. We want you. We want to know you. Now, in your heart, pray a prayer to the Lord about this. Amen. Thanks for joining me today at Kingdom Kids. And, it looks like I gotta run. But remember that God loves us so much that we just have to love others. See you next week.